Hey there, it's Brie, and these are my recent reads. These recent reads are from October 22nd to November 1st, and in those 11 days, I read 12 books. So I'm just going to go through and talk about the books in the order that I read them. The first book that I read was Sugar and Gold. This is by Emma Scott. I gave this book 5 stars. It was so good and very, very unique. Unlike most of Emma Scott's books, it has a kind of like speculative, magical element to it, but it also is a contemporary and it reads like a contemporary romance with just a little bit of magic thrown in. So the hero is an empath, meaning he's very sensitive to other people's emotions and he can sense other people's emotions by looking at them because of the colors that surround them and the different colors mean different emotions. It almost gives him like this mind reading type of capability. And because of this, he kind of lives not on the run, but he doesn't stay in one place for very long because he gets very overwhelmed by heightened emotions. And so when there's a lot of people around, it like messes with him because he's so perceptive to people's emotions and it affects him deeply. So he travels a lot and the way he earns money is by playing poker and he's good at poker because he can read other people's emotions so he knows when they're lying. So he's a really good poker player and earns money that way. And he travels a whole lot until he meets the heroine and she is just a little bit different from everyone else. He feels a little bit of a reprieve when he meets her and it like calms his visions down a little bit. He still can see what she's thinking and what her emotions are, but he's much more attuned to her and she also relaxes him a little bit. It's a really, really, really good book. Of course, it's Emma Scott, so it's very emotional as well, but it's just really, really good, very unique story. I really enjoyed reading this one. I did end up reading it for the Audible Escape to the End Readathon. It was on Audible Escape. I don't know if it's on Plus though. The next book that I read, because it was October, of course, was Before You Ghost by Helena Hunting and Deborah Anastasia. I haven't read anything by Deborah Anastasia aside from books that she's written with other people, including this one. Felony Ever After, I think, is the only book that I read by her, and that is a collaboration of a bunch of different romance authors, and I really liked her chapter, so I was excited to see that Helena Hunting was doing a book with her because I wanted to read more by her anyway, and I figured that this was going to be pretty good. I love Helena Hunting. It also just sounded good because it's a ghost romance. The hero is the boyfriend who has just died, but the heroine can still see him, and it's supposed to be really funny and everything. This book I gave 2 stars because it was just dumb. Like it just wasn't good. Like it got absolutely ridiculous and then it just wasn't it. Like I am so here for ghost romances and there is another ghost romance on here that absolutely worked and it was also a novella. This one just wasn't it. I think I just had too high expectations maybe going into it. It was like not funny to the point of being kind of dumb. So didn't enjoy that one, unfortunately. Third book I read is A Duke by Default. This is Reluctant Royals book number 2. It's by Alyssa Cole. I gave this book 4 stars. This one, I don't normally like royal type romances, with the exception being the Royal series by Emma Chase. I liked Royally Matched by her a lot, and I liked that series. This series, I've liked a lot of the books in it. I gave one of the books 5 stars, and then this one I gave 4 stars. This one's probably my favorite aside from the novella, and I think it's only because the novella really didn't have anything to do with royals, and this one had very, very little of the royal thing in it. The hero is Scottish, and the heroine is traveling to Scotland from America. She's known for being a little bit flighty and a hot mess, essentially, is what she calls herself. She's trying to get her life together and she wins this apprenticeship with the hero. He works for this company that like makes swords or something, and she ends up really helping them with like their marketing and things like that. They don't get off on the right foot and then they end up like having this enemies to lovers romance, but it's really good. The next book that I read is To Hate Adam Connor. This is by Ella Mays. This book was so funny. The way Ella Mays is, I love Ella Mays so much. She has the sense of humor that I love in books. It's like a little more than subtly funny, but it's not over the top funny. And I just found myself like giggling throughout this whole book. I read this as part of the Audible Escape Readathon because it was on Audible Escape. And I gave this one 5 stars. I don't know if I said that already, but I gave it 5 stars. I don't normally like romances where one of them, especially the hero, is famous. And the hero is an actor in this one. He's also a single father. She ends up, for one reason or another, moving in with her friends who are the characters from To Love Jason Thorne. So it's Jason Thorne and then the heroine in that one. They live next door to Adam Connor, who is the actor, and she ends up moving in with them for a short period of time. She ends up in this enemies to lovers relationship with Adam Connor because she technically is spying on him, but as she's doing that, she ends up rescuing his son from drowning in the pool. And he, instead of like thanking her, is like, oh, she's a stalker, and like has her arrested and thrown in jail for a night. And so she hates him after that. Like at first she thinks he's super attractive and stuff, but then after that she hates him. But then it ends up being this enemies lovers romance, and it's just, it's really, really good. And I love Ella Mays. Like, she's quickly becoming one of my all-time favorite authors. Next, I read Dirty English. This is English book number one. This is a contemporary Pride and Prejudice reimagining of sorts, and it was pretty good. It was kind of forgettable. I didn't feel like anything really stood out to me, and it didn't feel very Pride and Prejudice-y. The hero is a fighter. I can't remember. I think he maybe is an MMA fighter, and they are neighbors. Like, the hero and the heroine are neighbors. So if you like neighbor romances, maybe give this one a try. I am going to give this author another try. This is my first by her, and I've heard good things about her, but this one wasn't my favorite, but I did give it 4 stars. Next, I read The Highlander. It's Victorian Rebels, book number 3 by Kerrigan Byrne. This one was really, really, really good. I am absolutely loving the series so freaking much. It's a dark historical romance series. This one wasn't quite as dark as some of the other ones, though it is very dark. It does start off with like a bang. It's definitely lots of triggers. The heroine is abused by her husband and assaulted, and like he basically lends her out to other men, and she's tortured, and it's awful, 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 until the hero from the first book actually helps her escape and then puts her undercover as a governess to go be a governess for this single dad Highlander who has a very like dark reputation in the war. And so she's a little bit scared of him when she first goes there. And they have a little bit of an enemies to lovers thing going on, but it's so, 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 so good. I gave it 5 stars. Next, I ended up reading Halloween Boo. It's Holiday Hunk book number 1 by Sarah Spade. I read this for the Paranormal Readathon, and I gave it 5 freaking stars because for what it is, it's really good. It's the ghost romance that I had been wanting, like the ghost romance novella, I should say, that I wanted. It's what I wanted Before You Ghost to be. The hero is haunting the heroine's apartment, and she can't see him, and she can't really communicate with him, but she knows he's there because of little things that go on. And then like only on Halloween does he have a physical form, but it's really good. And I love how he's like very obsessed with her. And I'm so here for like the obsessive guys in romance novels, like not in real life, but in romance novels, I love it. And that's how he is. Like, he has fallen in love with her just by like being around her all the time. It was really good. Like, for what it is, it's 5 stars because it's funny and it's cute and it was just exactly what I wanted to read, and it was perfect to read on Halloween. The next book that I read for the Paranormal Romance Readathon was another dark novella. It is The Necromancer's Bride by Brianne, Hale. I gave it 3 stars, and I think, honestly, I may actually bump this up to 4 stars because I actually really liked this one. Okay, it's super weird. Like, for what it is, though, I really liked it. I feel weird saying that I really like a book that is like this because it's so freaking weird. I feel like some of you might read it because I like it, and then you'll be like, what is wrong with you? Because a lot of weird, very like strange things happen in it. But for what it is, it's like an erotic novella. And I have a feeling Brianna Hale just has a weird mind, and the things that she thinks of, I have no idea where her head is at, but I was like right there with her the whole time. I don't know. I feel so weird saying that, but I liked it, and I'm gonna give it 4 stars. Like, I don't know what to say. But anyway, this is about a girl who as a child got really sick, and her parents brought the like town necromancer down from his like castle on a hill or wherever he lives and had him come and heal her, or maybe bring her back from the dead. I think maybe he just healed her. I don't think he brought her back from the dead. It fast forwards to later when she's older, and kids in the town are starting to get sick with the same sickness that she had, and they're all like blaming her. So she goes to see the necromancer and she's like, hey, like, can you save these people the way that you saved me? And he's like, yeah, but you have to like stay with me and like live with me or whatever. And she's like, okay. And then she does. And then all these sorts of like super, like he tries to like seduce her the whole time. And then all these super weird things happen. There's like a disembodied hand and there's slime and there's a dude that he like controls by mind. And it's just, it's intense, but I also liked it. I don't know what to say. I'm sorry. Next, I also read for the Paranormal Romance Readathon, Smashing the Pumpkin King by Holly Ween. And this one I didn't rate. I think I'm going to rate it 3 stars because again, this is another situation for what it is, which is it's a novella. It doesn't take itself very seriously. I mean, the author's name is Holly Ween. And it's supposed to be funny, it's supposed to be steamy, it's supposed to be ridiculous, and it absolutely was all of those things. So the book opens and the heroine is at a pumpkin patch and she's attracted to a pumpkin. She's attracted to a pumpkin, like right from the very beginning because of the face that's carved in it. It's a very handsome face that's carved in it. It's ridiculous. I'm sorry, just like talking about it is ridiculous. But anyway, so she brings it home and then he turns into the Pumpkin King and he is an orange dude. Like he's a big orange guy. And he smells like pumpkin spice. And there's so many, there are so many descriptions that I highlighted in this and so many parts that I read to my husband because they were ridiculous, but it was entertaining. And at no point did I feel the need to like throw it across the room because I hated it. So I'm giving it 3 stars. What can I say? And then I read Awakened. It's The Oracle Chronicles, book number 1 by Moni Boyce. This one I also read for the Paranormal Romance Readathon. The heroine is a witch or an oracle, and the hero has been like protecting her. He's a shifter. He's been kind of protecting her from afar. I think they work together and she thinks he hates her because he like gives her dirty looks, I guess. And he like never talks to her at work, but it turns out he's been protecting her this entire time. It's also a forbidden romance because he is not supposed to let her know that he is protecting her. And she doesn't know what she is initially in the beginning of this book. So it's a very forbidden romance. It was really, really good. I really liked it. I gave it 4 stars only because it was like losing me in a few spots for some reason. It could have just been a me thing, but I was having a hard time paying attention and connecting to the story at first. But once it got going, I really got into it and I enjoyed it. So I gave it 4 stars. And then the last book that I read was The Warlord Wants Forever. It's Immortals After Dark, book number 0.5. So it is the prequel to the series. It's by Cresley Cole. And it's funny because when I did my TBR for the Paranormal Romance Readathon, a couple of people in the comments were like, oh, don't read this one first, you'll be confused. But actually, I did read this one first and I actually loved it and I wasn't confused at all. I adored this book. I gave it 5 stars. I am obsessed with a heroine. She is everything that I love in a paranormal romance heroine. Like, she is badass. She uses sex as power. And she like taunts the hero. That's something that I love in romance novels, I'm realizing, is when the heroine like taunts the hero with her body and her like personality and just uses that against him and it works. The hero is a vampire and the heroine is a Valkyrie. And she, in the beginning, she is a prisoner and she's like watching him from like the prison window as he's like defeating the people that imprisoned her. And he's not going there to save her. He's going there just to like kill the people that imprisoned her. And she's just like watching and like waving at him from the window and stuff, even though she's a prisoner. Like, she's so awesome. Like, I love her so freaking much. She's one of my favorite heroines of all time. And I'm actually reading the first book in the series right now and she's in it very little. But the little that she's in it and also the hero is in it, I am obsessing over it because I read this book. So I'm actually really glad that I read this one first because it makes me appreciate the little things in the first book much more. But anyway, I love their romance. I love what she does to him. Like, she tortures him like bad, bad. And it's fantastic. And I love it. I loved it. It was great. And I can't wait to read on in the series. Like I said, I'm on like the last chapter of the first book. So I'm almost done with it. And I'm really enjoying that one too. Anyway, those are all the books that I read recently. Let me know down below if you read any of these books, which ones you enjoyed, which ones you didn't. Let's talk about them down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, happy reading.